Well, I think there's a new element in this because you're thinking of the past oil crises of the 70s and early 80s, right. And when the price of oil went down to $20 a barrel.
Is it
oil,
now?
And well, now it's about $40, right. $45 a barrel. But when it went down to $20 a barrel in those days, a lot of the new industries that were starting were killed because they couldn't compete.
It wasn't economically feasible.
That's correct. And so, but there's a new element in all of this. First, times are different. The developing countries are beginning to develop. When the world does come out of this worldwide recession, we will know long term. It's hard to predict what prices will be next year or 3 years from now, but in the long term, considering what's going to be happening in a growing economy with the developing world wanting to share in the prosperity that we enjoy in developed countries, that these things require energy, so there will be a higher demand.
Well, that's already true. Look at China, look at India.
Absolutely.
In terms of China now, you know,
and there's
huge appetite for energy and huge emission problems.
Right. So there's a growing appetite that we weren't as conscious of. It wasn't as apparent in the 70s and early 80s. And there's a new 800-pound gorilla in the room. Let's be frank about this. And this is that carbon emissions have. Most scientists agree that the carbon emissions that humans are responsible for have, in fact, begun to change our climate. And the risks for that could be substantial.
Join us online at charlierose.com.